In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Google Tag Manager to send data over to Google Sheets and use it as a lightweight tracking tool. All and more coming up right after this. Hi there, and welcome to another video of measureschool.com, where we teach you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and on this channel, we publish marketing tech reviews, tips and tricks, and tutorials, just like this one. So if you haven't yet, consider subscribing. Now, Google Sheets has been a great companion over the past few years in analyzing, automating, and discovering data. For example, you can check out our video on building dashboards with Google Sheets down below. Today, we want to bring together Google Tag Manager and Google Sheets to build a lightweight tracking solution that you could utilize, for example, to log errors or send data in that you don't want to necessarily store in Google Analytics itself. This is all based on a blog post by Margarita from ganotes.com, which I will also link up in the description below. Now, we got lots to cover, so let's get started. All right, today our journey starts here with a new plain Google Sheet that we want to fill dynamically with data through Google Tag Manager. And this should actually act as our database, each row representing a single data point. Now, what data do we want to send in? Well, let's replicate Google Analytics events. So let's say we want to track, first of all, the timestamp when the event happened. And then the familiar properties such as category, action, and label. To demonstrate all this, I have set us up with a little bit of an example. In Google Tag Manager itself, I've built up an event tag that registers add to cart clicks on our demo shop. So when we click the add to cart button, an event gets sent over to Google Analytics and it is registered in Google Analytics. Now, what if we wanted to send that data over to our spreadsheet and keep a record here in Google Spreadsheet itself? Well, you know that Google Tag Manager is capable of sending data to multiple tools at the same time. We just need to integrate this. Unfortunately, there is no tag template or no default way to send data into a Google spreadsheet. So we need to make use of something called Google Scripts. That's available here under Tools and the Script Editor. What do we enter here? Well, let's head over to the mentioned blog post by GA Notes. And we have here a script that is handily prepared, which we can simply copy and then paste it in here. Let's name this all. This will be our event logger script. Save this. And there are a few configurations that we need to undertake in order for this to work. First of all, we need to define this sheet name where the data should be stored. So in our Google spreadsheet, we have here our sheet name. We can use whatever. It is by default sheet one, which is also what is named here. And then we need to insert the sheet ID. Now the sheet ID is what you see here between the D slash and the slash at the end here, between edit, that's the ID. Let's copy that and enter that into our document as well. All right, let's save this. Let's save our sheet. Let's rename that really quickly into event logger. And now we are able to publish this script. Let's go to publish and deploy this as web app. And then the important part is that you choose down here who can access the app. It needs to be open to everybody. Don't worry, only you know the actual URL and will be able to use it if you don't deploy it openly. Let's deploy this, review our permissions. We just need to allow this. And we get a URL. Now, what will this URL do? Let's try it out. It will give us a response saying that the script was executed correctly. What happened? Nothing really, but we have a new line here in our Google spreadsheet with the timestamp category undefined, action undefined, label undefined. Now, why are they undefined? Well, we didn't actually put in any query parameters into the URL. So let's do this really quickly. Just to show you how it's done, you can add a query string by putting in a question mark and then key value pairs, whatever you have defined in your spreadsheet. So first of all, the first property would be timestamp, which is automatically filled. So we won't need that. Let's go on with category. You put in category and in between you put the equal sign and then the value that we want to post. In our case, let's go with test category. Let's do the same for the other parameters, separated by an and sign. And once we have it filled out, let's execute it. And we have a success message here. And now our row has been filled with the actual values that we had filled into this URL. Now, why is this so awesome? Well, we can use this URL to fill our data in dynamically via Google Tag Manager. So how we would do this if we wanted to recreate this event call of Google Analytics? Let's look into the event call itself. We see here the category is always clicks. The action is filled dynamically with the click text and the label is filled with the click URL. Cool, so let's recreate this by going into tag. This is a sheets tag, which also fills in event data for our add to cart click. As the tag configuration, we'll this time choose the custom image tag. Now the custom image tag only takes one parameter, which is an image URL. It doesn't really have to be an image. It can also be simply a URL that gets called. So we can input our script URL here. Now we need to fill again our query string. We had our category, which is always the same as clicks, and our action, which is dynamically filled by the click text. So we can simply use our variable here, separate this with an and, and our label is dynamically filled with our click URL. We keep cache busting enabled and simply use the same trigger that we use for our Google Analytics event. Let's save this and try it all out. Refresh our preview and debug mode, go back to our page, refresh that. And I click the add to cart button with the command key pressed, so it's open up in a new tab and we'll be able to see still our preview and debug console. And we see our event has been sent to Sheets. Now we should be able to see this in our spreadsheet itself. Now you may ask yourself, why is the label empty here? Well, let's go over to our page and look at the actual tag itself. You can see this was the URL that was executed. And in fact, there is no label attached. We used the click URL variable, so that should be appended. Why wasn't that appended? Let's click on the event that triggers our tag. And then under variables, we should be able to see our click URL. Here it is. And it's in fact empty, and therefore there was no value transferred. And that's because this add to cart click is not actually a URL, but rather a JavaScript call to the shop platform. So the user is not really redirected in terms of a link. But let's say we wanted to change this to the page URL just to make it a bit more useful. You can do this really quickly. Try this all out. And here we go. We can see there was an add to cart click on this particular page. So I hope you can see that this can be really useful if you simply want to recreate something outside of Google Analytics. I could also see this as useful if you want to track data that you're not able to track within the confinements of Google Analytics, or just because it's not allowed to track that data within Google Analytics, or you want to structure data differently and connect it up to another spreadsheet or do any kind of calculations within Sheets itself. The whole script is very flexible, so you can change the properties up here and still send in the data. You will need to still use the script in order to make this work, but these are the basic steps on sending data in to Google Sheets via Google Tag Manager. So there you have it. This is how you can send data from Google Tag Manager and store it in a Google Sheet. Quite practical, don't you think? Well, what else could be done with it? I would love to hear from you in the comments below, and please share your ideas so everybody can learn from them. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, and if you haven't yet, consider subscribing because we bring you new videos every Wednesday. My name is Julian. Till next time.